Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1997, Copy Subtotals. And podcasting this whole book, go ahead and click that I in the top right-hand corner there for the playlist. Well, this is my last example about subtotals, and one of my favorite stories. This goes back to 1997. I was working at my last day job. My manager needed a report. I had a large data set. I added the subtotals. I went down to the number 2 view. I set the print range. Gave him that report, and he was thrilled with that report. He came back, he said, "Hey, just send me these rows," right? And he was standing behind me when I did this, Control C, Control N, and then at the Control V, it brought all of the detail rows and no way to collapse them, right? And secretly, unbeknownst to this guy, I'm already running MrExcel.com at night, and he's back there. He was one of the most bizarre managers I've ever had. His arms were flailing. He said, "Of course it didn't work. You didn't use visible cells only." I'm like, "Visible cells only? What are you talking about?" He says, "Well, first press Control G." Back in the day, this was, you know, back Excel 97, you had to use either Control G or F5 to display the go-to dialog box. And you may have heard me rant before that I have no use for this dialog box because, well, if there's only two places that you need to go in a spreadsheet, the top cell, which is Control Home, or the last cell, which is Control Down Arrow, or Control End, right? There's plenty of places to get to the two places I need to go. I don't need a stupid dialog box to get there. Now, hey, in parentheses, the last time I said this in a podcast, 1,000 episodes ago, someone pointed out this is a great place to get to a hidden column. And yes, you're right. I still have that trick. So I rejected the go-to dialog box. I hadn't looked at it for 10 years. And at some point, since I rejected the go-to dialog box, in the bottom left-hand corner, Microsoft added a button called Special. This is classic Microsoft. Let's have a really good, really powerful, really useful feature and put it where no one will ever discover it. So, useless dialog box, go to Special. This is amazing. Go to Special. It says, hey, within the selection, we're going to narrow the selection down to, maybe just formulas. Maybe just formulas that are errors. Maybe just blanks. Or in this case, what my manager was talking about, visible cells only. All right, now the good news, I guess, is that it's a little easier to find now. Home, find and select, go to Specials actually on a menu, and then visible cells only. Click OK. See the little white lines there? That's saying, hey, there's things that are hidden that you can't see. When I do the Control C, it's really obvious the marching ants or the dancing ants or whatever you call those little things are around each individual row. Control N for new and Control V to paste, and we get just those total rows, and they convert the formulas to values, which is the right thing to do. I remember explicitly this day, I turned around to that manager, I said, "Where did you learn that trick?" And he says, "I read it in Excel Help." And I'm like, "What? Who takes the time to read Excel Help?" All right, so there you go. Of course, in the last couple of days, you've seen me use alternates to this. Alt-semicolon. Alt-semicolon is a great way to go. Or yesterday, I added the Select Visible Cells icon to the Quick Access Toolbar. Another great way to go, all right? So some way or another, before you do that copy, you have to get down to visible cells. Well, all of the podcasts this month, plus all the podcasts for the rest of the month and probably 2 weeks of September, all in this one little book here. It's so much knowledge compressed in the palm of your hand. I'm going to ask you to go out and buy the book. $25 in print, $10 for an ebook. It's cheap. Recap of today's episode. First, we add the subtotals, collapse the number 2 view, and then when you go to copy those subtotals, new workbook and paste, all of the detail rows come along, and there's no way to collapse it. You have to use go to special, and back in the day it was go to, which was either Control G or F5, click the special button. Now you can get there easier, select visible cells only. That go to special dialog box has all kinds of great uses. After you select the visible cells and copy, you can see the marching ants, go to new workbook and paste. They automatically paste values, which is awesome. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.